Hello. Now, of course, before we start chirping on, a thank you. A thank you very much, everybody. I'm getting plenty of views. More is always required. Please share my tips, my defensive riding tactics amongst your friends and amongst new riders. Please, on your social networks. If you see something, you can copy and share it. I'd appreciate it if you would. It might save somebody's life. On that note, thank you everybody for my views and all my subscribers. I'm not going to say just the recent ones because I still appreciate the ones I've already got, but I've still got people hitting the subscribe button. I appreciate it. Thank you. Onwards. I have a question, and it's not a tip. It's just about, I'm looking for opinions. Are on the road costs a bit of a scam? Now let me think about this carefully and let me explain what I'm talking about. I'm not having a go at any dealers, I'm having a go at the industry. As you can see, I'm now riding my new, if slightly dusty and partly used, 1600 kilometres now in about 3 weeks, Tenere T7. Now I'm not having a go at the dealers, especially not having a go at my dealer who sold me it, because I like the guys, and they're part of an industry though. Now, 30 years ago, I was selling motorbikes, and it was a multi-franchise dealer. We sold Triumph, BMW, Honda, Yamaha, Ducati, price of a new bike, etc., plus on the road costs. Now, I'm going to talk specifically about the industry and why I'm a bit confused. And I don't know whether it's always been the same in Australia, I was in the UK, and whether it's different there, I do not know. But on the road costs, back then, was it specific to my dealer? I don't know, to the dealer I worked for. Were we that kind where the on the road costs covered your first service? Now, I've just paid a bit of wind, not me for a change. I've just paid $300 for the first service at 1,000 kilometres. On top of what was basically approximately $1,200 on the road costs for the bike. Now, I've only done 1,000 kilometres. What do they do? Levels and pressures, and an oil and filter. So oil filter, they'll check the air filter, give it a clean if required, specifically to a bike like this where I've been off-road, but they'll clean an air filter, levels and pressures, and an oil and filter change. And that cost me $299, and I actually think that's a bit of a discount. So I think I got 10% or something like that. I think it's 320 or something like that for a retail price for the first service one of these. But should that be part of the on-the-road costs? Which leads to the question, should the industry be quoting a cheaper price plus on the road? Why can't they just have a price? That's your price, that's what you get. PDI, pre-delivery inspection, forget it. Just do it and quote the price. Have one price. That way, nobody's being shady. Nobody's being, oh yeah, that's your price, $15,800. You rock up to pay for it. Oh no, there's another $1,200 to pay. And then there's another $300 on top of that for your service after you've done just 1,000 kilometres. And it suddenly becomes an even bigger money pit than we thought, this motorcycling game. And we know it's expensive. I knew, and I had a feeling I was going to be paying for my first service. I don't know why, but in times gone by, new bikes, where I worked, the first service was free. Or so they said, but actually it was taken up by the fact that you'd paid an on-the-road price. I apologise in advance for the next sneeze. Is it going to come? Probably in a minute. Hang on. Thank you. Oh, there's going to be more. Nice. So, let me know. What are your thoughts? Should we be paying on the road costs? What's your thoughts? How much have you paid? Or should they just include it in a price and that's it? And then should we pay for the first service? Why can't they just include it? That way, when you've done your first 1,000 kilometres, which might be a couple of weeks or a week, depending on how far you go, you're not shelling out another $300 because you've already spent 17 grand, let's be honest. Why do they have to quote 15.8 and then bang on this extra bit of information? Oh, yeah. Because you go on Auto Trader or, you know, Bike Trader or bikesales.com.au as it is here, and you'll get all the same bikes, and you'll get some dealers that are selling these bikes for 20 grand and they've got all the extras on, and they're saying, oh, by the way, that's your price you pay. I like that, but what they've done, of course, is put 3 grand of extras on as well. So some people are quoting 20 grand and not being bothered about the fact that that looks like $4,200 more than the retail price, which is $15,800. But there are people quoting $15,800 for these, and then in brackets, plus on the road. So they're quoting the cheapest price that they can, legally. But when you rock up and when you try to pay, yeah, but you're then going to have to pay for delivery, inspection, build, and your on-the-road costs, such as your rego. Fair enough, your rego is a separate entity here. But it's just a bit of a scam. It's sales techniques. It's this, it's that. There's various things. What's your thoughts? What do you think? Should it be just one price and that's it? We're not going to shaft you when you rock up and say, by the way, there's another $1,200 on it. Quote the price you'd expect it to pay, in my opinion. When it comes to your first service, that's how much it's going to cost you. Or it's included in your on-the-road costs. Where should we be in this as a motorcycle industry? In my opinion, should be one price. Forget quoting on the road. Going back to that other one, I've seen these at 20 grand, but they've already fitted everything you're going to do anyway. A lot of people are going to do what I'm doing and adding all the extras. So I've seen one in New South Wales or Melbourne, I can't remember which one it was, one of the deals over there, and they've been dead straight. I can't remember who it is, but they've gone, yeah, by the way, it's got headlight protector, bash plate, engine guards, racks, and knobbly tyres. Already done, because you're going to do it anyway. This one's ready to go, and it's going to cost you 20 grand. Are you ready for it? Buy it. Boom. Boomf. You know where you stand. So yeah, let me know what your thoughts are. Should we be paying on the road costs, and what should they be, and should it include your first service? My thoughts.